In the previous video, we have presented the analytical solution for the L-lambda element matching network. In this video, we are going to discuss the L-lambda element matching network by using Smith chart solution and to introduce how to solve this problem by using Smith chart, we start with an example. So, it is required to design an L-section matching network to match a series RC load with an impedance Z load equals 200 ohms minus J100 ohms. This would be connected to a 100 ohm transmission line. This means that Z node is 100 ohms at frequency 500 megahertz. So this is the center frequency of the matching network. So at the center frequency, the normalized load impedance, it would be Z load over Z node, would be 200 over 102 minus J 100 over 100 minus J1. It can be noted here that this load impedance lies inside 1 plus GX circuit. This means that the appropriate L-shaped network, would be consisting of a barrier GB connected to a series GX. Now it is required to determine the value of B and X, which can be used to match this load impedance. Actually, we start on the Smith chart by laying the load impedance on the Smith chart. So, the normalized load impedance is 2 minus G1, would be located at this point. We go along the real axis until 2, and because the imaginary part is negative, we are going in the lower side until we intersect with the arc G1 minus G1. So this is the point of Z load. This is the first step in our solution. The second step in our solution is to draw the constant reflection circle. To draw the constant reflection circle, this is the center of the circle, which is the center of the Smith chart. The radius of the circle would be from the center to the point of Z load normalized, and then we draw the constant reflection circle. The third step is to connect the point from Z load to the center of the Smith chart until it intersects with the constant gamma circle. This intersection would correspond to the load admittance, Y load. So, in this case, the value of Y load is from Z axis is around 0.4 and at the Y axis is around 0.2. We read it. How? We read it by going to the constant real axis until it intersects the real axis, it is around 0.4, and we go along the constant arc until we intersect here, it is around 0.2. Okay? So, this is Y loop. The first step, locating Z load. The second step, constant gamma. The third step is to determine Y load. Okay. Now the fourth step is to draw the circle 1 plus GX. We are going to draw an inverted 1 plus GX circle. It is exactly the same like 1 plus GX, but on the other side. Okay. So, this means that the radius of this circle, it is 1/4 of all this line, because this line is the radius of the complete Smith circle, Smith short circuit. So half of this would be the radius of 1 plus gx. So we are going to draw exactly a similar circuit to 1 plus gx, but in the other side. Alright, this is step 4. Maybe step 4 is to allocate y load. Step 5 is to draw the inverted 1 plus gx circle. Rotated 1 plus gx circle on the admittance chart. Here is a rotated 1 plus gx. Rotate just as this is the angle between the two circuits, or is 180 degrees. Okay. Now we have y load. We are going to move along a constant real part y load to change its imaginary part. This is actually due to the variable gb. Here I have y load, and in addition I have gb. So the total admittance here would be y load plus gb. If y load is real part, assume that g load plus gb load, okay, and here we added gb, so the total admittance here would be g load, which is the same real part, but the total imaginary part, the total susceptance, it would be b load plus b. So we are going to move along the real circle until we intersect with the rotated 1 plus gx circle. So we are moving from y load along the constant g load circle, or r load circle. Actually here we are talking about g load, the constant g load circle, until we intersect with 1 plus gx circle. This means that this point has the same value of the real part of y load, because g load is the same here, 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 and here. But the admittance has been increased from gb load to gb load plus something to reach this value. Actually, this value, it was 0.4 plus j.2. Now, this point is 0.4 plus j.5. This point is 0.4 plus j.5. This means that I have added gb equal 0.5 minus 0.2, which is 0.3. So we already obtained the value of b as gb equals j.3. Now we are talking about admittance, but we are going to take z load barrel to gb in series with gx. If we are talking in series, we are talking about impedance, because impedance in series are the summation. So at this point I'm talking about the new admittance after adding gb. This admittance is converted to be impedance. To convert it as impedance, we are going to extend a line from this admittance to the origin of the Smith chart to the other side with the same distance, until we intersect with the 1 plus gx circle. Until we intersect with 1 plus gx circle. So we intersect here at the step 7 at input impedance Z equals 1 minus J1.2. This means that the input impedance seen after adding barrel JB would be real part equals 1 but imaginary part equals minus J1.2. Okay, so this is the point at the input impedance at here. Okay, to make the input impedance after the series GX to see the input impedance to be unity, the normalized input impedance, this means that the value or the required value GX, it should be J1.2, such that Z, which is 1 minus J1.2, plus GX, which is J1.2, would be the input impedance or the normalized input impedance would be unity. So after adding the value of X, which is J1.2, the input impedance, the total input impedance here, or the normalized input impedance, would be unit. Means that it is matched to the transmission line. So, from this analysis, we obtain the value of JB equal 0.3, and the value of JX is 1.2. B is positive, it means that B is capacitive part, or in other words, J omega C equals 0.3 multiplied by Z naught, J omega C, which is the susceptance of the capacitor, equal J 0.3 Z naught. So we can see that C equals the value of V over omega 2 bar F multiplied by Z naught. This means that it is required to add a barrel capacitor here equals 0.92 picofarad. On the other hand, GX, the series GX, if it is positive, it will correspond to series inductance. And series inductance, it will be J omega L. So in this case, J omega L equals J1.2. In other words, J omega L would be J1.2 multiplied by Z naught, because this is normalized to the characteristic impedance. This means that the value of L would be the value of X multiplied by Z naught over omega 2 by F. And in this case, the value of inductance L is about 38.8 nanohertz. So the solution of our matching network in this case would be a barrel 0.29 picofarad, barrel capacitor 0.92 picofarad with a series inductance 38.8 nanohenry. Okay? As we said in the previous video, we have two solutions. So what will be the second solution? Actually, the second solution will have the same steps, but we start with Z load to obtain Y load, but instead to intersect with the rotated 1 plus JX circle from this side, we are going to intersect from the other side. If we remember, Y load here, it was 0.4 plus J0.2. 0.4 plus J0.2. Now, if we are going to intersect in this side, actually, this is the circle. This is the circle of Y load 0.4 until we reach This is the circle point 4. Until we reach to the intersection circle here, it is point 4 minus j point 5. Point 4 minus j point 5. So point 4 minus j point 5, and it was originally point 4 plus j point 2. Means that the value of V in this case is minus j 0.7. Okay. Now, from the intersection point, actually, I'm afraid that this should be not this point, this should be this point, because we are talking about the constant R value. Constant R value is this point, not this point. So we are talking about this point, this J point 4. So actually, this red line is not correct. Actually, the intersection point should be here. The intersection point should be here, and this point is actually 0.4 minus j 0.5. 0.4 is the real value. The real value is here. This is the circle. This is the circle of 0.4, and this is the arc of minus 0.5. Okay. So actually, you are talking about this point, not this point. Right, we are talking about this point, and from this point, which is 0.4 minus j 0.5, we are going to draw a line to the origin which intersect with the circle 1 plus jx here, and in this case we are going to find that the intersection would be at the point 1 plus j 1.2. 1 plus j 1.2. Okay? So, the required series reactance, Gx, in this case, would be minus j 1.2. So, everything is the same, but instead of going in the positive x direction, we are going here in the negative x direction. So, this is solution 1 and this is solution 2. In this case, the value of B would be minus j 0.7. And the value of X would be minus j 1.2. The negative value of B, it means that B is inductance. So, here we have B as inductance. And the negative value of X, it means that X, it would be capacitive. So, in this case, or in the second solution, the parallel element is inductance and the series element is capacitive. The value of B when it is inductance is 1 over omega L equals the value of B. And B here is normalized, so B multiplied by Y naught or B over Z naught. B over Z naught. So, in this case, the value of L would be Z naught over the value of B multiplied by 2 by F. Okay? And here is the negative sign of B. So, L in this case would be Z naught over B or over omega B. In a similar way, the value of X here is 1 over omega c. 1 over omega c would be 1.2 multiplied by z naught. Okay? 1 over omega c equals the value of x multiplied by z naught. This means that the value of c, it would be 1 over omega z naught x. Once again, 1 over omega c equals x. This means that c would be 1 over omega x. And here it is normalized to z naught, so 1 over omega x z naught. By introducing these values, we can obtain the value of L, or the quad L, is 46.1 nanohenry, and the value of C, or the required value of C, is 2.61 picofarad. Okay. Now, actually, this solution is exact at the center frequency, which was 500 megahertz. The question now is, what about the solution when we are going to deviate from this center frequency? So, this is the behavior of solution 1 as a function of the frequency, and this is the behavior of solution 2 as a function of the frequency, and this is the reflection coefficient. It can be noted here that solution 1 is nearly symmetric, which is was composed of barrel C and series L, but solution 2 is more matched at higher frequencies but less matched at lower frequencies. Actually, according to the required bandwidths, we can select which would be more appropriate. For example, if we are interested in matching symmetric, solution 1 would be better. If we are looking for solution which would be matched at higher frequency mainly, solution 2 would be more appropriate. Okay?